I found the nuggets down in the stream. I got the gold, is what I scream. Yeah, I'm a gold miner out in the wild that digs for free. I found the
now
nuggets.
I know that he's a gold miner
in the stream.
But he's still just an old timer.
Found the nuggets.
Now I know that he's a gold miner.
Welcome to another camp in the woods.
Okay.
This time I'm here with my good friend, Mr. Kit Andrews, whom I'm hoping is going to be a good chef for me on this excursion. He's manning the barbecue. We have the honey stove here in the foreground. Also on this occasion, making her debut, is Jess. Jessie, look, can I say hello? Good girl. Jessie is a six-year-old Patterdale stroke crossed Jack Russell Terrier. And she thinks she's found a rat. What is it, Jess? What is it? Also making its debut for the first time, is my new Helter Fors axe. A nice medium-sized forest axe, ideal for gathering wood for the fire. So what have we got in here, Kit?
Well, just a while back, I went to a field just over the road there and I just took about a pound or so off the side of a cow, minced it up, and we salvaged a garden just down the road. There I got a leek and a carrot.
Looks lovely.
And a parsnip. It's a bit young, the parsnip, but there's some celery in there as well.
Oh, lovely.
And and some mushrooms that we picked off the common just down the road.
Yeah, so this is proper bushcraft, hunter-gatherer type of foraging, really, isn't it?
I always cook in a wok. Now you might remember this.
That's the ash spoon from Ash Spoon Cops
video. That is
video.
Sandy's ash spoon from Ash Spoon Wood from a few videos back.
And my wife Mandy, whom I made it for, didn't really like it, did she?
But I'm just going to let that simmer away there over the coals. I know, maybe for half an hour. I mean, it's what, 5 to 6 now, 6:30 tea time.
Yeah, I reckon so. Lovely.
And a bowl of that. It's a shame I forgot the scotch.
Never mind.
Because I tell you what, a tot of scotch tossed into that, and stirred round just at the last thing, that is a meal and a half.
Maybe bring the scotch next time.
Eh. This really is the restaurant at the end of the universe, isn't it? If you remember the book by Douglas Adams, Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, the second part of that, The Hitchhiker's Guide to the Galaxy, bear in mind it was a trilogy in four parts, but if that makes any sense. But if you saw the BBC version of that, Peter Davison played the part of the cow in the restaurant.
All right.
And the cow said to Peter Davison, "Which part of me would you like? My rump is very nice." So that's what he had.
Oh, lovely.
This is what we've got here. The restaurant at the end of the universe. A bit of arse end of cave. normally I'll just knock his horns off, wipe his arse and have it there and then. But for the sake of Sandy and the video, we're cooking it.
And tell us a bit about your occupation, please, Kit.
My occupation? Well, my occupation is I'm a gold miner. I'm a gold panner. And where we are at the moment, I'm not going to tell you, because some people that know me will want to get in on this gold mine site. So
yeah, but I know where it is, and it is Miner's Wood.
Miner's Wood. Well, there we go. That'll do for me. Miner's Wood. But Now, it's very, very pleasant here. You know, the water's running just down, just over the back there, about 15, 20 yards away. You can't see it from here. We're in a nice little secluded glade within the forestry here. And, I mean, for me, this is ideal. This is home from home.
That'll do for me too.
Okay. Right, there we go. It's chow time now. So,
that looks lovely, Chris. I'm looking forward to this.
Yeah, there we go. Well, if you'll excuse us now, it's chow time. We're going to dive into this with relish.
Went back in 1906. This here was actually a gold mine. The entrance to the gold mine in the Forest of Dean. You can just see the railway tracks there. There's a quick tour of the campsite. Chris himself is sleeping in a more conventional manner, in a tent, whereas you'll have to follow me.
Well, as I've always said, if you got it, use it.
If you got it, use it.
Yeah.
If you follow me this way. And here's my humble abode for the night. A tarp strung between two fir trees and a hammock set up in the conventional manner. Although I have, in this instance, attached a secondary line under the tarp so I can hang things in that, which makes it easier to find your bits and pieces in the dark hours. I'm trying to make another spoon. This time I'm going to try and burn an ember into the wood, form the bowl of the spoon first, and then once the bowl of the spoon's formed, then carve the shape of the spoon around that. Well, with a successful burn, I've managed to blow an ember and then create this circular depression, which is actually quite deep in my spoon, so I've scraped some of the charcoal out and now I'm going to carve the spoon around that. I'm quite pleased with that. Well, it took me about half an hour and the spoon now looks like that. And that's quite a good deep depression, so I'm very pleased with that way of forming the bowl. I've made another bannock, slightly different this time. It's two parts plain flour, teaspoonful of bicarbonate and soda, one part milk powder, and I've added to that whole hazelnuts and some pineapple chunks and the syrup and some almond, and I'm told it tastes very nice, so I'm going to give that a go.
Aye aye, everybody. Well, I don't want to get up, but anyway, I have to. The dog needs a walk. You can certainly see how useful the line was to me. That was my torch. Glass is just hanging there. socks, bag where I stored a few things that I might need. So really useful. Nice and comfortable though. Here's the view from the hammock. Mixed woodland. There's a mozzie there. Breakfast consists of noodles cooked on the honey stove and egg and bacon cooked on the barbie.
In a wok?
In a wok.
Pudding!
You haven't moved very far since last night.
I've been here all night.
I found the nuggets down in the stream. I got the gold, is what I scream. Yeah, I'm a gold miner, out in the wild, that digs for free. I found the
now
nuggets.
Now I know that he's a gold miner,
in the stream.
But he's still just an old timer.
Found the nuggets.
Now I know that he's a gold miner,
in the stream.
But he's still just an old timer.
Won't you gleam?
In time it will all be mine.
See what I mean?
In time it will all be mine.
Won't you gleam?
In time it will all be mine.
So it seems.
In time it will all. Gold's what he found when he was looking underground. Now I'll pile it up in mounds, weigh each 100 pounds. You say I'm already rich? You can tell by my...